Good morning students, standard 6. Today I am going to teach here science, and then name of the topic is motion. Then this is your chapter 12. Listen students, suppose someone asks you, can you really tell whether something is in motion or at rest? अगर कहीं पूछा तुमको, okay, कौन सा चीजों के बारे में? ये moving है या rest है? ये move कर रहा है या rest है? तो तुम लोग आसान से बोल पाओगे, क्यों ना? Anything that changes its position with respect to time, okay, the body is said to be in motion. ये motion है बोल के बोला जाता है. और जो मूव नहीं कर रहा है, ओके, एक ही जगह में है, उसको बोला जाता है रेस्ट. गॉट इट? बट मोशन का बारे में बोलना, कौन सा ऑब्जेक्ट का मोशन का बारे में बोलना उतना आसान काम नहीं होता है. ओके, इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट इन सम केसेस. अगर हम लोग रिलेटिव मोशन के बारे में विचार करेंगे, ओके, let us read some examples. Okay, suppose you are sitting near a window in a train. To you the trees outside seem to be moving backwards. जब तुम लोग ट्रेन में सफर कर रहे हैं, okay, और विंडो का सामने बैठा है, तो जो ट्रीज है, okay, दोनों तरफ में तुमको दिखाई देता है, the trees are moving. Got it? But the person who is sitting outside the train, okay, to him these trees appear to be at rest. मेरा कहने का मतलब, जो चीज तुमको मौसम कर रहा है जैसा दिखाई दे रहा है, दूसरा आदमी को these things appear as if they are at rest. Okay, so यहां एक कंसेप्ट आता है रिलेटिव मौसम. Got it? Means the trees are moving or your train is moving. Got it? Relative to the trees outside you or relative to the persons, those who are sitting outside you. But for the people, those who are sitting here in the railway station, for them the trees appear to be rest. Got it? So ऐसा भी चीजों है जो तुम लोगों को क्या है, लगता है मूविंग कर रहा है जैसा, दूसरे को रेस्ट में है जैसा appear होता है. ओके, एंड दे विल बी सेम टू बी स्टेशनरी एट रेस्ट. ऑन द अदर हैंड द पर्सन सिटिंग नेक्स्ट टू यू विल बी, okay, at rest to you, while he and you will seem to be in motion to the observer outside. Got it? Take another example. When you look at the moon, it doesn't appear to move. हम लोग जब मून को देखते हैं, ये मूव कर रही है जैसा नहीं पता चलता है. But if you look it again after 5 hours, the position is different. Means so you know that it has moved slowly in relation to you during the 5 hours, and when you are not looking at it. Got it? Third example, if you stand at the center of a railway track, watch athletes run around it, they will be motion in relation to you, even though their distances from you remain same while they are running. So in this case, their directions from you or their positions in relation to you are continuously changing. Here, okay, the motion, the direction of the motion around you changes continuously. Got it? So two things should have become clear to you from the examples. Okay, motion is relative.
This is very important. Okay. Motion is relative. Got it? जैसा मैंने बताया, you two sitting in the train means another person relative to you is at rest. Okay, another person relative to you is at rest, but both of you are in motion with respect to the surroundings. Got it? And in this case, you will use the word. Okay, motion is related. Take the example of ourselves. Okay, sometimes we move. Okay, sometimes we move means we change our positions or we move to somewhere else. But if you consider in relation to earth, okay, in relation to earth, okay, we are at rest. We are at rest, but ourselves and the earth itself is moving with respect to the sun, okay, or with relative to the what? Sun. So this is about motion and relative motion. Something is in motion means its position with respect to the observer changes with time. Got it? Now let us discuss what are the different types of motion. Okay, types of motion. Type of motion. Okay, first one is linear motion. Okay, second one is the rotational motion. Third, circular motion. Fourth, oscillatory motion. And next, periodic motion. Okay, so these are the different types of motions. Let us discuss first linear motion. When a body moves in a straight line, like a ball dropped from a certain height, its motion is described as rectilinear, means it tracks a path of straight line. The motion of car down a straight road or that of a striker moving across a carom board are the examples of some rectilinear motion. When you fling a ball from the roof of a house, the ball follows a car path. Okay, suppose you are here on the building and you throw a ball. So what happens? It will fall here on the ground after traveling a car path. There also, it is known as what? Curvilinear motion. It means it making a car. Got it? So both rectilinear and curvilinear motions are together referred as what? Linear motion or translatory motion. So other name of linear motion is you can say what? Translatory motion. Okay, it also includes curvilinear motion, means motion along a curve. Got it? Next, rotational motion. The turning of a merry-go-round, a ferris wheel or a fan or a potter's wheel or a blades of a food processor are all examples of rotational motions. Because the body stays in the same place, but these rotate around an axle. It moves around an axis passing through itself.
Okay. In other words, though the position of the entire body doesn't change, the position of different points of the body keep changing with time. For instance, the seats of a merry-go-round keep changing position with time, though merry-go-round stays here in the same place. Okay. So this is about rotational motion. Next come to circular motion. When a body moves in a circle, okay, around a fixed point, it is known as what? Circular motion. When a body moves around a circular path, the way of, just like the earth moves around the sun or the moon moves around the earth. These are the example of circular motion. When you tie a string around an object and whirl it around, the motion of the object is what? Circular. Remember that in circular motion, the position of the body itself keeps changing with time. Okay? But in rotational motion, the position of the body doesn't change. Okay? Next come to oscillatory motion. Okay? Best example, the motion of a pendulum and that of a swing are oscillatory motion, because here the ball oscillates from the main position. See this one. This is the what? Norm of the pendulum clock. This swings, this come to extreme position, then again it come to, this is the main position. Okay. This is the main position. Again it comes in this direction, again it reaches the extreme position, means displaces, again go back, and this is repeated. Okay, so the means from the main position it displaces up to this, again it goes back, again it goes to this side, again comes back. Okay, such type of motion is known as what? Oscillatory motion. You already know that time taken by a pendulum to complete one oscillation is always the same. Here, in case of rotational motion, the knob takes a fixed time, got it? So, it is known as what? Periodic motion. Means, it takes a fixed time to complete one period. Next, other examples of periodic motions are, see, the motion of earth around the sun, it is also known as circular motion, okay, but it is periodic because it takes a fixed duration. Okay, but listen students, the beating of your heart and the expansion and contraction of your lungs do not repeat at regular intervals, so these are not periodic. Okay, also the swing or rotation is not always completed here in case of swing in a fixed time, so these are also not periodic. Okay, so this is about different types of motions. Thank you.